Jesus, I do agree that Jesus was primarily he did ministry in his 3 years for the people of Israel.
So this paraclete,
but then they hardened their hearts and
whatever reason, what other reasons they were not ready?
One of the,
remember, it has to be something that is not
the newer revelations then among the apostles would be the inclusion of the Gentiles. That finally it is time for the Gentiles.
Like Christ didn't ask, said Gentiles are okay to have.
Well, he started it with our whole lost sheep of Israel discussion.
If you believe that this is already taking place, then that's not a new teaching. You cannot have both ways. Either his mission was only for the lost sheep of the house of Israel, or was all-inclusive. If you accept he was all-inclusive from the very beginning, then it's not a new teaching by the Holy Spirit.
It was more progressive revelation to people than
But, okay. Do reflect at home, or later on in your own time, because you will be really struggling to find this new truth. I mean, from experience, this is what I have seen. But do reflect and see. But if it was referring to another prophet, another messenger, the whole thing changes. The whole mindset changes. If it was referring to another prophet, another messenger, like how the Jewish people were concentrating in Arabia, waiting for a prophet, how Paul himself went straight into Arabia, not going to Jerusalem, for a reason, it adds up that, okay, people are expecting a messenger, a prophet. Yeah. Why? Why did Christ say there will be many false prophets? But this is how you know the true prophet. Meaning what? There will be a true prophet to come. So if you look at holistically the whole thing, without the Christian faith bias, because if you're already a Christian, it will be very difficult to look outside. But if you say, let me just think, how, if I was not a Christian, how would I understand this? You will see that, okay, pointing to another comforter like him. He says another comforter, another paraclete, another, someone like him. Yeah, another with the teaching and so on and so forth. So the Holy Spirit in the Christian theology is not another comforter like him.
Are you going to pray?
He doesn't do what he taught and so on and so forth. It's something that you think you have within you, you know, guiding you internally, but it's method like what Christ did. Another discussion altogether. So, because it's getting quite cold, just to summarize this, I apologize if I've made any offensive remarks about your religion. This is not intended. We are just discussing the differences between our theologies, our doctrines, our belief, our ideology, so that we learn from each other and see where the truth is. Because if the truth lies wherever it is, we should be able to run for it and accept it. If the truth was in Islam, it should not stop you from accepting it. That's what I'm saying. If the truth is wherever it may be. So what we have to do for this is we have to be very sincere in our approach, be truthful, and be humble in our approach. Not be arrogant and stubborn, like many of us are. Ultimately, we want to worship God, and we want to have a relationship with God, and we want to go to paradise or heaven that God creates in the hereafter. We don't want to be the losers in hellfire. So we have to make sure very clearly that we're not worshiping other than God. And I've just given you information about how Quran tells us through the last messenger that if you worship God alongside other partner assigned to God, hellfire is the only destination and heaven is closed. So it's very grievous, it's very, you know, in terms of magnitude, this belief that we have to be absolutely clear and careful what we believe in. So as a Christian or a people of the book, there are a lot of information and invitation and requests and what am I going to say? Lot of things are waiting for you to discover in the Quran. The Quran speaks to you as all people of the book. You need to know what the Quran is saying to you. Okay?
I would like to learn more about Islam.
Yes, sure. So please do, and I leave it.
So that I can contradict it better. No,
whatever your approach is, but make sure your approach is sincere in finding the true God. Do you know we Muslims, we constantly pray at least 17 times a day. Establish us, guide us on the straight path. We are guided already, look.
I heard Muslim almost every day. We are guided. In Uganda.
Right. We are guided already in our belief, but we constantly ask God to keep us steadfast in our guidance. So, asking for this guidance, oh God, show us the guidance. and keep us steadfast in its guidance, there's nothing wrong with it.
I want to seek the truth just as much as you do, and if there's any truth in the Quran, I want to find it. If there's mostly contradictions, I want to find them. If it's all contradictions,
take up this task. Yeah, take up this task. Just be sincere and be reflective and be someone who would pursue this task for the sake of truth and for the sake of the love of God. Take care. All the best. All the best. May God guide us all closer and closer to the truth. Thank you.